we got these weird sort of skewed dice. Like usual dice are cubes, right? And these are not, these are kind of squished somehow. Or they're, well, they're a little bit sort of eldritch or like occult or distorted from the fourth dimension or something. And what's the first question?
Well, the first question is, are they fair?
Are they fair? Well, let's roll them and find out, shall we? I don't know.
Right.
Yeah, that looks fair to me. Yeah, well, so, you know, they work just like ordinary dice. And right, are they fair? Well, okay. This is an ordinary dice, so there's your, you know, your usual cube-shaped dice. So why do you think this is fair? Like, what is it about it that makes it fair?
It seems very symmetrical, and all the sides seem the same area. And...
Right. Yeah. So really, the reason why, you know, this thing, I mean, it's not actually fair because, you know, there's different, like, the six dents taken out of this, and there's one, and, you know, forgetting all that. Suppose it was an ordinary, you know, just a perfect mathematical cube. Physics sort of messes things up and it makes things, you know, bounce around in some crazy way. And you want to know that there's no bias, right? So here's a way to think about, like, what is it that makes this fair? So if I sort of take this away and erase all the faces and write new ones on and give it back to you, you wouldn't be able to tell that I'd done anything because it's got these sort of symmetries that I can, like, move this around. So it's about the symmetry. It's about, like, you know, I guess the three is the same as the five because you can move the thing to change the five into the three, but it doesn't change the shape of it. Okay, so now I got these things. So all I have to do is convince you that all of the faces are the same, that the symmetries that take any to any others. So there you go. Like, so you can see the threefold rotational symmetry here. Like, if I rotate it like that, it's the same. And then the three on the back, if I do this, they're also the same. So they're all the same as well. It's got the same. So the property is called isohedral. Isohedral is the property of a polyhedron, which is like the symmetries move the faces. You can move any face to any other face. I can rotate 120 degrees. I can rotate 120 degrees again. Whoops. And then I can do this switch around thing here. So these have like just enough symmetry. These have the minimal amount of symmetry you can have to be fair. Whereas your ordinary cube has excessive amounts of symmetry, you could say, right? I mean, there's extra symmetry. It's like this thing is the same as the same shape, but like it's still face two, right? So this has way more symmetry than you need, and this has just enough to be fair. This is a symmetry of the cube that doesn't make it any more fair, right? The two is still the two. Whereas this thing, there's nothing you can do that doesn't sort of mean that, right? So anything I can do to this that's a symmetry, it means that, you know, it moves some face to some other face, showing that, you know, and you need that for it to be fair. So all the things are like necessary here. Okay, so we have like six-sided dice, and people have seen like 10-sided dice and 20-sided dice. How far can you go, right? So, well, if you want a fair die, right, so this is a 60-sided die, which has the same sort of symmetry properties as we were talking about before. Every face is the same as every other one. So here's face 24, right, and I guess I've got face, what's the opposite of 24? Because they have to add up to 61, right? Because that's what you do on dice. So 24, there's 37. You turn it around, and I guess maybe you have to turn it upside down again, and then it makes it the same shape after you're done. So 24 is the same as 37, and you can do that with all of the other ones here. One problem with this is that it's really round, so it kind of rolls forever. So we can try and do it like, yep. Oh,
what's
oh,
gonna
there
be?
We go. One.
You rolled
wow.
A one.
That's a critical fail, I think, on a D60.
This one you're showing me now looks kind of fair again. Does
right.
This one have excessive symmetry, or is this one as bare minimum?
Well, it's getting tough. Like, when you get to 60 sides, like you run out of kind of symmetries that you can do. There's one extra symmetry this has that isn't necessary in some sense, which is the reflection, right? So, like, you can see a line of a mirror symmetry there. So there is a way to, there is an isohedron, a polyhedron that has the symmetry thing with 60 sides. The only problem, like, I really wish we could have done this. The only problem is that it doesn't have opposite sides parallel. So when it lands on the table, there isn't an obvious face that's up. It's kind of, we're really disappointed actually that we couldn't do that. But yeah, so that there are like a couple of other candidates out there with 60, which have a little bit less symmetry, but they don't work for other reasons.
Can you make bigger? Can we go?
Can you go bigger? Yeah. So So there is one more thing you can do, which is a 120-sided die. I can actually sort of explain how you do it just looking at this. So this has got 60. And as you say, it's got too much symmetry, right? There's this reflection. So what you do is you take each of these, you see these sort of kite-shaped faces, and you divide it into two. And you have two little triangles, one either side. And then you've gone from 60 to 120. So we're working on it.
Do you know about Number File 2? That's our second channel where there's bonus footage and outtakes. Make sure you see the extras from this video, they're really interesting.
So this is a skewed version of the D12, which is similarly weird.
And while you're there, why not subscribe to Number File 2? That way you'll know all about the extra stuff I don't always mention here on the main channel.
Mirror symmetry, which means that, of course, we had to do both of them. Right, so we had to make two mirror image pairs because, I don't know, it's the right thing to do, right?